One of the things we have not featured yet that I'm stung by all the time is, of course, the jellyfish. I'm hearing a lot of bad information out there about how to treat a jellyfish sting and what the sting is actually doing. So when I decided that we were gonna make this video, I was like, what jellyfish should I get stung by? A little tiny one out on a reef? Oh no, I need to go big. We're talking the baddest, the terror of the ocean, the Portuguese man-o-war. Now, when the wind blows a certain direction, the Portuguese man-o-war will actually wash up on the beaches here in Florida, sometimes by the hundreds. Actually, I think I see one right up there. Oh, all right, here we go. Those are two pretty good looking man-o-war right there. So everyone knows this is the end for them. When they wash up on the beach here, they will unfortunately dry out, and that's kind of it, circle of life. So the fact that we're taking these two today for our experiment is totally a good use for their end of life. Sometimes with beauty comes pain, and this is a super painful jar. I remember these tables, except all of the shoots before this one, I was on the other side of the camera. So yeah, this is a little bit different than I'm used to. Although it looks like one, the Portuguese man-o-war is not actually a jellyfish. It is a siphonophore. Unlike a jellyfish, which can survive on their own, siphonophores are a group of colonized organisms made up of clone cells. Each group are responsible for specific tasks to keep the man-o-war alive. Some cells form the float, which suspend the organism on the water's surface and create a sail to move with the wind. Others are responsible for hunting prey, and this is where we meet the venom-filled nematocyst. These small but potent cells cover the man-o-war's stinging tentacles by the thousands, and within each is a spiral-shaped barb which literally blasts out when making contact with its victim. When these barbs penetrate the skin, they release a cocktail of enzymes very similar to snake venom. These enzymes are designed to incapacitate prey, and in my case, will cause instantaneous pain. In this bucket, we have a variety of different sting remedies, some of them good, some of them not so good. And that's the reason why I wanted to make this video in the first place. This animal is notorious for its sting. In fact, it stings thousands of people here in the state of Florida every single year. I luckily have never taken a sting until now. Time for me to take two stings from the Portuguese man-o-war.
Today I'll be taking two stings side by side on the same arm. One of them to be treated with urine, and on the other, I will spray white vinegar.
Please do not attempt to do what I'm doing here today. About to take two stings from the Portuguese man-o-war. You guys get your shots ready because this is only gonna happen one time. Terror of the ocean, here we go. One, two, three. Ah, yep, it's getting me. Oh yeah, I can feel it. Ah, ooh, ooh, that's like electric. Yeah, that's one. Wow, it burns right away, okay. Second sting, I gotta do this fast before that gets too bad. Ready, guys, ready? All right, one, two, second sting, three. Ah, yep, oh. Man, that one nailed me. Oh. Instant, almost tingly, electrical feeling sting. A lot different than a bee sting or a wasp. And it is getting worse and worse with every second. First sight, vinegar. Here we go. Okay, now the one I'm dreading. Oh, 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 it stinks. Oh. Scraping off those active nematocysts is certainly part of the equation, so you don't want to forget that step. I can actually see my skin pulsing. You guys can see my skin going up and down there. Vinegar, not only more sanitary, but definitely wins the contest. This is by far the least of the two when it comes to pain. So I'm gonna go ahead and call it. Vinegar is the definitive antidote that you want to use if you want to neutralize stinging cells on your skin. Urine, not your best friend when it comes to a jellyfish sting or a man-o-war sting for that matter. And there is one last step that will truly alleviate the pain symptoms that I'm feeling in my arm. Good old-fashioned hot water. The reason hot water is the ultimate antidote to a man-o-war sting is because the heat from the water will actually denature the proteins in the venom, rendering them inert, completely harmless. And then it's just up to my body and my immune system to do the cleanup work, and I'll be as good as new. Oh my gosh, guys, this is, I've never had a hot conference. Feels so good. Like immediate relief. And I hope everybody watching not only enjoyed this little experiment, but learned something to take home with you. Don't use urine, use vinegar to treat jellyfish stings or man-o-war stings. And at the end of the day, hot compress is going to be your real solution.
While I did experience slight discomfort for the next few hours, the scrape and heat treatment reduced my pain to that of a mild sunburn. And by the next day, nearly all signs of redness had vanished and I was as good as new. So next time you're on the beach and you see a man-o-war, avoid it. But just in case you don't, some white vinegar and a hot compress seem to do the trick. So yeah, you should leave your pee in the toilet.
And if you want to learn more about what's going on here, we do have the article from the University of Hawaii in the description. There's more science, there's more facts in there we weren't able to cover this afternoon. But I do wish you the good fortune to never encounter a man-o-war for yourself so you can avoid a sting like this. I'm Mark Vins, be brave. Stay away from man-o-war. We'll see you on the next adventure.